Check this out, I got busted once, and I had this little bicycle light, because I'm a tweaker, I do meth, you know, when I'm out there. And I had this bicycle light, but I didn't have a bicycle, I just had a bicycle light. It didn't work, so I pulled the batteries out, and I took my quarter ounce of speed, that was about my daily habit, and that's no BS, man, I used to be skinny, now I'm fat. And I shoved it in there, and I had it in my pocket. And then I went walking into Home Depot with my big heist planned up. We're going to get some walkie-talkies and some ski masks. We're going to make it a four-man job. Hell no. I'm pouring sweat. It's the wintertime. I am soaking wet. I'm sweat. So I did this big issue. And I couldn't hit my hands on where they're gone. So I hit. It's time to go stealing. And I go walking in there. And I've got me a Home Depot card to swipe. It's not my Home Depot card to swipe. And, oh, man. This is a war story to have. And I get busted. I get busted, not because I swipe the card and they realize, beep, 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 it's stolen, nothing like that, no. Because I'm pouring sweat and water's dripping on the floor, and I figure, somebody's going to notice. So I see my homie outside in the truck, and I go walking out there to wave him in so he can push it open and swipe it. And the minute I walk past the threshold, Lost Friends go, fuck Reagan! And I'm all, ah! And it was on. I turned a $200 drill into a robbery case. A robbery case. Well, anyway, the power greater than myself that would send me here shows up, and they had me cuffed, and a guy can smell the ether coming off me, and he's like, where's the dope? And I'm like, I ain't got no dope on me. And I can see this flashlight, this bicycle light sitting on the counter there, and he takes out of my property bag, and he starts swiping the things in there, and he just takes that light, and he throws it in my property bag with the, along with his Home Depot credit card. Oh my gosh. It didn't have a name on it. And the only thing that I had on me was just a wallet that had other cards, like casino cards, no ID, nothing like that. It's the first thing to go. So when I go to jail, and I'm sitting in jail, this guy up here is just something special. So I'm sitting in jail, and the whole time I'm in there, I can hear that bag of dope, that quarter ounce of dope sitting in my property going, I'm waiting for you when you get out. I'm like, oh no.
Did you find it?
No, they didn't find it. It's in my property bag. And the substance abuse assessor, God, I love you, Mr. Martinez, but I'm about to pull my own covers if you watch this. He shows up and sees me and he's like, do you have a problem with drugs? I'm like, are you kidding me? And just because I got no drug problem doesn't mean you can't still smell the meth coming out of me. What are you doing? Wow. You are simple. He's like Ricky Bobby. You ever seen that movie, Talladega Nights, and Ricky Bobby's all, I'm not sure what to do with my hands. First commercial.
Oh, yeah.
This is Ricky Bobby urging you never to go to Tijuana. We might have to go to Tijuana, bro, by the way. I just have to, if we're going, just saying, Robert. Like, anyway, so I go, he comes and sees me, and he's like, well, we're going to get you out. We're going to get you into a program. I'm like, yes. And then I can hear the meth of my property going, yes, I'll be waiting for you. And I get an early release, and he comes and he picks me up straight from the jail to take me to rehab, right? And he takes me to this mountaintop rehab. And this place is like an hour drive from down from the city. It's far away, and they hand me my property before I walk out. And there's that light, that bike light with the quarter ounce of speed in it. And I'm getting taken by the substance abuse assessor straight from jail to this mountaintop rehab mall. This is never going to work, right? This is never going to work. All right, we're going to be having our own radio show coming here soon, but I'm going to go off on this little tangent here. What's going on is, in my head is, oh my God, I want this to work so bad because I'm so sick of being locked up. I'm so sick of being busted and disgusted. I hate it in there. I hate Pinochle. I don't want to play no more spades. That's no, bad. I don't want to, I mean, it's fun. Yeah. You know, but I don't want to have to play spades as the only means of entertainment. I like porn. I like women.
Look at this. So, real so, food.
Yeah, I like potatoes that actually are potatoes. Not, well, we do have some.
I like potatoes that are actually.
This is as good as it gets in jail. If that's the best you can hope for, whereas out here, potatoes.
We've had that for 6 months. We don't have to eat it.
We don't have to eat it. Well, I just keep it here to remind myself. Right? By the way, I'm not sure if this is any good anymore. Throw it away. I'm not sure if this is any good anymore. Throw it away. That's quite an analogy for the things that no longer serve us in our lives. Let me show you a little bit of message here. All right, Dan? Message. So, what do we do about the things that no longer serve us? The ego. The, stop filming the ceiling, bro. the ego, that which is inside of me that keeps telling me that it's going to be okay again, that I can someday beat the game, I can control and enjoy my using as if my using is enjoyable while controlled. I've tricked myself into going out and celebrating not getting loaded by getting loaded. I'm like, yeah, I haven't gotten loaded. Let's go get loaded to celebrate. And, you know, I'm feeling good. I'm feeling better. And I'm doing the things that make me feel better. And my head goes, well, I don't need to do those things anymore. I feel better.
This is your former response.
So one more time. I'm released. One more time I get released and I'm up in this mountaintop rehab. And I don't want to do the dope. I don't want to do the dope. He's our sign language interpreter. He's trying to distract me. And he's doing a good job. Right? So I don't want to do the dope. So I'll call on people. Hey, bro, you can come have this. It's about, at that time, it was like $150, $200 worth of dope. You can have it. Just come get it. You know? Before I wanted to do it, I screwed this whole thing up. And they didn't show up. Right? And I'm thinking to myself, man, I got this great opportunity up here. I'm on a mountaintop. My friends won't even come get the dope for free. But I can't bring myself to flush it. Because in the back of my mind, not in a quiet voice at all, in a very convincing voice, I hear, go ahead and do a little. I'm like, what the fuck did you say? I don't like waking up at 6 in the morning. Why don't you we got chores to do. Just do a little bit. A little bit of meth. Not too much, just a little bit. And after days of trying to get somebody to come on board and grab this dope for me, I finally hear it loud enough. Just do a little bit. That voice has gotten louder and louder, and finally I'm like, you know what? I'm just going to do a little bit. So I pull this little itty-bitty shard out of there, and I eat it. It tastes terrible. And I want to shoot it, because that's a rush that I can't even describe here. I'll start getting weird. And the next day I ate a little bit more, and then I started crushing it up in the bathroom in a bill and snorting it out of there. And anyway, I take what used to be my daily issue, 7 grams of speed, meth, the highest fucking stimulant known to man, and I make it last a month. A month. Now, mind you, I didn't enjoy any of them. Excuse me, ladies, but I'm jerking off real slow so my bunkies don't know. I'm sweating in the wintertime. I'm writing like there's no tomorrow. I'm getting hand cramps. I'm thinking people are talking about me. Who's saying that? Do they know? Are they on to me? Right? And I know that if my friends won't come get this stuff for free, they're certainly not going to bring any more. So this has got to come to an end. But I can't flush it. I'm not enjoying it, but I got to keep doing it. Because my brain's telling me, that retard, that addict, that maniac up in my dome keeps telling me, I say we get high. He gets his vote every single time. You know, and he's always going to get his vote at the table. What, did you get goosebumps? That idiot's always going to get a vote at the table, right? He always is. The thing is, what I've been able to do from 12-step anonymous meetings, from educational stuff, from finding out the root cause of my problem, from doing meditations, from doing self-care, from working with others, from being of service, from praying to a God I don't understand, from talking to the brain and believing in aliens, from doing all these different things. I see one of those go to meetings, work the stuff, get a sponsor. I'm like, da, 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 da. I got to employ a lot of things to combat this thinking because I was high longer than I've been alive, it feels like. You know, like, think about it. I didn't sleep but every fourth or fifth day, and I'd still only be like 3-4 hours in. I dreaded the prospect of a nap. It never happened on my planet. I never laid down in a bed to go to bed. No, I would drop. Singing.
A big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place. Somebody better put your bag into your place.
We will, we will.